men's 200-meter final. The defending champion Michael Johnson sitting next to us after pulling up injured in the U.S. Olympic trials. So the main American hope now rests on the shoulders of 21-year-old John Capel, the former Florida football player, taking a leave of absence from Steve Spurrier's Gators. And here he is in the Olympic final, and he's looked good so far in the competition. Lane one, Claudinei da Silva of Brazil, silver medalist last year at the World Championships and last year's Pan American Games champion at 200 meters. In lane two is an American, the former Auburn Tiger, Kobe Miller. Miller was the runner-up to John Capel just last year at the NCAA Championships. Here he is in the Olympic final. In lane three, Christian Malcolm of Great Britain. Run a personal best here in Sydney already. 1998 World Junior Champion at 200 meters, just 21 years old. John Capel is in lane four. They call him John John. His dad, John Sr., is a Baptist minister who is here in Sydney to watch him run. In lane five, Konstantinos Kinteris of Greece, trying to become the first Greek man to ever win a sprint medal, the 100, the 200, the 400. He also has looked good, winner in the semifinals. He's a phys ed teacher in Athens. In lane six, Darren Campbell of Great Britain. He was sixth in the 100 meters last Saturday, the former soccer player coached by Linford Christie, the 100 meter Olympic champion. Obadeli Thompson of Barbados is in lane seven, the bronze medalist in the 100 meters last Saturday. In Atlanta, he finished fourth in the 200, an NCAA champion at Texas El Paso. And in lane eight is Otto Bolden, representing Trinidad and Tobago, trains with Maurice Green in California, bronze medalist in Atlanta. He won the silver in the 100 last Saturday. John Capel, the youngster, has looked good.
He has looked good. And after those trials in Sacramento, he came up to me and said, I'm going to make you proud. And he's a good kid and very respectful and a lot of talent. Over in Europe, he didn't perform as well, and we spent a lot of time talking about that. But he's regrouped and got back with his coach, and he's got his parents here and the support of his parents, as you see there. And he's on his way. He looked good throughout each round and has started to focus more as he gets through each round. So I think that he's ready to go here.
The pride of Brooksville, Florida. Michael, we were saying earlier that 110,000 might be awesome to some of these people, but as a former Florida football player, he's very used to big crowds.
He is used to the pressure. He didn't do too well in Europe, but I think here he's gotten used to this crowd and these people here in this huge stadium, and he's gotten better with each round.
There's the start at 200 meters. Looked like Capel flinched just before the gun and then was left in the blocks. Here they come to the top of the home straightaway. Otto Bolden, Obadeli Thompson are there. Campbell of Great Britain and Kinteris trying to close. And here comes Capel. Kobe Miller also has a shot. Anybody's race. Here comes Kinteris of Greece. Kinteris of Greece, the first Greek man to win an Olympic sprint medal. No one talked about Konstantinos Kinteris of Greece, a phys ed teacher in Athens, the great national record holder. All he did here in Sydney was just keep on winning. Michael Capel lost all chance at the start.
Because the starter here has been holding very long, and Capel felt that and flinched, but that was a false start. His feet never left the sensor, so the recall starter, feet never leave the sensor, you see right there. So the recall starter didn't get the sensor in his ear. But you'll see what the recall starter should have seen here is a visual. Once you get in the set position right here, you can't move. That's illegal. That's a false start. He just moved. He knew that. The recall starter didn't know that. He knew that and he stopped.
I mean, I saw it from here with binoculars. Why couldn't he see it?
He's relying on the sensor, which is actually secondary. Primarily, you would rely on the visual. But Capel, not having that experience, he said, I'm busted. So he stopped. But you got to try to get away with it because you never know what might happen.
An inconsolable John Capel, to paraphrase an old baseball saying, he was wrong. Capel, trackside. Let's hear about that start.
John, did you feel as though you false started there?
I did. I thought I false started. I flinched and I came out. He never called it back.
Were you waiting for the gun to call you back?
Yeah. Yeah. I should have just kept running. I did the same thing at NCAA's in the 60s.
Otto Bolden repeats his bronze medal performance from Atlanta, and here are his thoughts on the possible false start.
Otto, you just spoke to the head judge out on the track, and you asked him why it wasn't a false start to John Capel. What did he say, and did he see it?
What I asked him was that did he see something irregular at the start, and he said he did see John Capel. He said, but what he saw from John Capel did not occur to him to be an unfair start, and as a result, he did not sound the recall gun.
And what was your impressions having seen the replay?
I still haven't seen it correctly, but I have a feeling I know what happened, that he must have flinched from the blocks and then rocked back in the gunshot. They should probably have called it back, but you know what? That's why the Olympics are tough, man. When the gun shoots, you got to go. And it's unfortunate because John Capel was definitely somebody who could have been a contender for the medals, but that's the way it is.
Thank you for the explanation, Otto.
Thank you.
Capel winds up last. Kobe Miller is American teammate seventh. For the first time since 1928, except for the boycott year of 1980, the Americans are shut out of the medals at 200 meters. Quinteros time in 20.09, Campbell the silver, and Bolden the bronze. Konstantinos Quinteros of Greece, right here, looked like he didn't have a chance, but he explodes in the final meters, passing that knot of runners to get across the finish line and make some history. The Olympics were born in Greece, but this is the first time in the modern Olympic Games that a Greek man has won a sprint Olympic medal, and the next Olympic Games, Summer Games, will be in his hometown of Athens.
Meanwhile, Capel had run 19.85 at the U.S. trials, and everyone expected him to be capable of going under 20 seconds here. Keep in mind, the winning time in this race was 20.09. That's the slowest winning time in the Olympic 200 since the boycotted Moscow Games of 1980. They're able to calculate Capel's reaction time, and it turns out it was nearly twice as slow as anyone else in the race and cost him any chance to win. Not only did Michael Johnson, the 200-meter world record holder, find fault with track officials, the IAAF rulebook indicates that a false start should have been called under these circumstances. Hard luck for Capel. As for the winner, Greece's Konstantinos Quinteros, perhaps Cub fans can now take heart. It's been two millennia since a Greek man has won an Olympic sprint. Seriously, as far as we can tell, the last was Dionysius of Alexandria back in 269 AD. His exact time is unknown insofar as stopwatches were unavailable and sundials were ill-suited to the sprints. Back to women's long.